A lot of Fortebracios for keyboard warriors. I mean, almost every single, probably like 70% of the. All right. We're on round three of the series. Yeah, let's see. Oh, split. So I'm going to maybe go from this side just so we can see it a bit more. Added that. Yep, here we go. They're starting to push in. Oh, going for some of the hero kills.
Oh, look at that Falco fire, though. Super brutal.
Yeah, they're getting so in their face. Cannibals. Silent One might get taken out here. Mall grab. How is Silent still alive? That was crazy.
Tank musket.
Sneaky musket. Yeah, right. All right, let's get down into the action a little bit.
Through the breach. Are they in the pocket? They are. They are in the pocket, getting their mortar set up, getting their Falco set up to shoot down the A tunnel.
So, as you can see, there's that fence, right? That fence is really... Ooh, Isma Black jumping on. Oh, three, four. Yeah, they have quite a lot. Quite a lot on there. They're throwing short swords onto this... Yeah, this is a really strong push by Keyboard Warriors.
Move now.
Yeah. They're definitely going
shooting back, though.
Heavy. Grape shot dropped over there, too, to keep pressure on that right side of A. But they need to shift over and get all these kills. If they can pick up a lot of these kills, that would be huge for Keyboard Warriors, 100%.
Yeah, particularly now, yeah, like you say, this is now the time they need to grab them. As EG makes that decisive retreat, which I think they're calling now, although a few of them are still hanging around, surprisingly. Maybe trying to cover the retreat of another unit with those fourth brashers there, but...
Ooh, yeah, they're getting... I mean, EG getting a kill there on Flynn, and then another kill there.
Now they need to run. That musket is going to be in trouble. Falco's killed with a treb there at the back into EG's Falco line, which is kind of a nice little treb placement there.
That's good. Yeah, they need to use them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Going to look at what EG did and use that as an example of how to push it.
Their advantage. Yeah.
So, it's been like a common thing amongst both. Ooh, the fight's happening right here. Let's take a look at this.
Yeah, here they go. Here comes the push. Yep. They got flamed up this time as well.
Yep. Oh, it's getting crazy. It's hard to tell what's happening, but you got flamethrowers going for the push.
Yeah.
With
the napalm laced across the battlefield. It's hard to see.
Yeah, there's just a lot of imp walks happening. We have Fortebracios backing them up. Not so much shields. Yep. There's a few shields, but nothing crazy. Stormy getting a kill on Weeds.
Lost five heroes here now in this push already. Look.
Yeah, they're definitely losing a lot of heroes. Hydra getting a kill there. Killed Tri-Link, but Flynn dropping here. Yeah, they're going to have to fall back here.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I mean, those Fortebracios are putting in work, but they're about to get triple teamed here by short swords, which is not going to be good. It's not good for the Falcos.
Yeah, I feel like EG's almost playing like a Uno reverse card on Keyboard Warriors here. You know, Keyboard Warriors have always been about getting those hero kills.
Nice stun shot.
The other way around.
Absolutely. You're just seeing a lot of action. That's on the other side for EG. They're about to set up here and fight again, but only 7 deaths for them. 12 for Keyboard Warriors. So let's jump right back into this action.
Keyboard Warriors still got the unit lead, so it's still all to play for here. They can still drag this back, but here we go into the next main push.
Yeah.
Those Falcos, it looks so beautiful.
Let's grab from this side a little bit. Let's take a look.
Oh, so much Falco fire coming in. We've got another treb coming in from Keyboard Warriors.
Yeah, that could be a good treb.
Stack of Stalwarts. It could.
It could be a good treb.
Got off some of those Lanchnecks.
Ooh.
A few Armagers coming down here now as well.
Oh, a lot of grape shots. Look, they're using the grape shot method. Yep. Oh, Hippie died from Socialist. Hooligan getting a kill too on Dervany.
Oh, yeah. And here comes the Armagers on the flank.
Nice flank. Charge. Not even a flank. That was straight on. Like, they just didn't have anything braced. Yeah.
Absolutely. Just waited for his opportunity and pounced. And that has given EG the unit lead.
Huge. Lead start. Go for it. Swite is, trying to keep pressure here over on the hillside so they can get a foothold. But EG is looking very good. Very, very good. Another treb. Ooh, that might be a decent treb. That could be a decent treb.
Oh, pull this star wars forward. Oh, that actually goes in.
Oh, oof. Yeah.
I thought that musket was toast.
Yeah, a lot of fighting happening on this side. Oh, Flynn going for it. Oh, the Hussar charge from the side. That's actually melted all those units. Wow, creating a huge opportunity there for Kibo Warriors. They have EG on their back foot here. This is not looking good for EG.
Oh, what a push, right?
Ooh, starting the cap point. Oh, the grape shots are all over. Yude and Kazdan getting to the back line, but they might be they're very low on numbers here. Very low. They have 8 to 13, 7 to 13. If they keep getting these hero kills, this is gonna be GG. And Keyboard Warriors might just get this.
They've got the unit numbers, but they just can't get them into play because most of their heroes dead.
Oh man,
they're bringing in more troops. But the Azaps coming in from the side flank.
Oh, the Zaps can be huge. Yeah. Oh, all right. So units are falling back. 11, 10. Oh, they're coming back.
Yeah,
oh, wow. Oh, Hussar charge. Oh, look at that. That is huge. Oh, but I mean, so many pikes.
Yeah,
It's going to hurt them a bit there.
Sergeant set up on point now. I think they've regained it. I can't believe it.
They do have a foothold now. It's 9 to 14 and EG with the bigger numbers right now. Wow, that was such a huge push by Keyboard. That was huge.
Wow, so close. Yeah.
They show they have the potential.
Push. Yeah, that was a really quality final push.
Ooh, let's watch some of this fight. Let's see if Far Cry can pick some people off here. Oh, Starmie getting the kill there in Far Cry. If they could have got that foothold and kept it, they easily had it on the hero numbers. But the units, it came down to units at the end there. And that really hurt Keyboard Warriors. And again, they're going to have to go to the drawing board and see how they can keep those units.